Okay, welcome back to the temperature measurements. Now we will see that resistance temperature detector. We are going to shortly we are calling as this temperature detector is RTD measurement. So in this RTD measurements, there will be one secondary unit will be there, and resistor will be there. And this resistor is we are going to connecting to that two wire system. And then we are going to measuring that temperature. Generally, this equipment, this object, whenever we are giving that temperature, so the object is going to be changes. Means temperature of an object means the area will be the going to be changes. Changes will occur. So generally that we are going to using this metals over here. Earlier we are used bimetallic strips over there. Also we are going to using this material is platinum material and nickel and copper, and we are going to generally commonly we are going to using this as a sensing element. And this type of instrument we are going to calling as RTD temperature measuring instruments. So we are going to calling as resistance temperature detector thermometer we are going to calling. Now we will see that what are that advantages and disadvantages of RTD. It will give that very very high accuracy. So why we are here, we are going to using good metals. So that that's why it will give that very accurate temperature measurement. So that a very high accuracy and stability is very excellent, and we can change that interchangeability. Means here we are highly accuracy, we know that. Means accuracy means exact temperature of the human body. Suppose take that human body temperature will be that 98.6 degree Fahrenheit. That will be commander into that 32 degrees degree Celsius. Okay, near about 32 degrees Celsius. So that is accuracy, we can say that. Whereas another one more word is there, excellent stability. So stability means once this temperature has shown, that stability temperature will be shown by next experiment also. That's why we are going to calling as stability. And another one is interchangeability. So this is a very big term. We are going to seeing that interchangeability means here we can use another equipment also we can use. Now I am going to using engines. You can use that electric motor, or you can use in boilers, or you can use in any other temperature measurements. Say that electrical motors also we can use it. Means that this we can use it anywhere. So that's why we can call it as interchangeability. So another one big advantage is ability to measure that very narrow spans suitable for remote measurement. Wherever we can say that we can take it this RTD and we can use it, no problem for this. And at the same time, disadvantages will be there if mechanical damages will be the more. Whenever heating error will be the more. Heating error will occur, it will give that noise. Means if the temperature crosses a certain limit, the plates is going to be vibrate. So that over there noise will occur. And instability is more when we are going to using that electricity equipment we are going to measuring over there. Disturbance will come, instability will be there. Suppose say that the motor is running, the RPM of the motor will be that more and more. So that temperature is also varying over there, instability will be there, particularly in electrical motors. Remaining mechanical equipments, there is nothing will be there, it will show that stability. Excellent stability will be there is no doubt on that. Next, we will see that pyrometer. It's also one of the good temperature measuring instrument. So it generally measures that heat. So generally, this pyrometers we are going to using that radiation temperature. Suppose that radiation temperature, there is no media between that source and that object. So that is called as radiation. There is no media. Okay. So here the device generally we are going to comparing with the brightness of the radiation of the object. Suppose bulb is lightening. So that how much temperature is releasing by that bulb, we can measure it with the help of pyrometer. So one setup I am going to showing here. You see that one eyepiece will be there. This optical lens will be there, and then optical lens there will be a temperature of the source. The temperature is passing to the bulb, and then this bulb is going to connect it to the rheostat and a battery, and one more thing is that multimeter. So multimeter we are going to measuring. Generally the rheostat, generally it will change that current brightness, okay, and brightness, okay. Absorption screen is fitted between the optical lens and reference bulb, so that it will be increase the temperatures. So with the help of this setup, optical means we are going to using this optical lenses, so that that's why it is called as optical pyrometer. Okay, in this optical pyrometer we cannot measure that exact temperature difference. So very limited applications will be there. That can also we can discuss. Generally from that how that this pyrometer is works means, radiation from the source from it will be emitted. So then the lens will be that differentiate, and then the temperature is going to be passing. The generally the lens will be helped for thermal radiation on the reference bulb, and then the observer generally with the eyepiece, the observer we can change that rheostat values, and then current reference the lamp will be the changes. This changes the intensity. So whenever intensity is intensity is going to be changing, so we can measure that temperature. So it is observed between three ways. So we can observe these types of pyrometer in three ways. See that one that filament is dark, then we are saying that cooler than the temperature source. One thing, filament is bright, so we can assume that hotter than the temperature source. Suppose filament is disappears, means it is not going to showing that one, then this there is equal brightness between the filaments and the temperature source. There is three types will be there: filament dark, filament bright, filament disappears. So that we are going to seeing all these things in this videos. Okay, so in this section, the according to that we can consider and we can follow that one. Okay, this with the help of pyrometers. So generally accuracy will be there plus or minus 5 degrees Celsius. High accuracy plus or minus 5 degrees only it will show that. Way it is very good advantages pyrometers. And another one more biggest advantage is that there is no contact between that pyrometer object and whose temperature to be find out, means there is no connection. So that's why this pyrometers is called as we are going to measuring that there is no media starting of this pyrometer. I told that so there is no any media and we are going to measuring. So this is that biggest advantage. There is no connection to measure that one. So another disadvantages. So minimum we can measure at least minimum 700 degrees Celsius. Then only we can go for this equipment. Not for small temperatures we cannot use this. Okay, light intensity. Okay, generally this pyrometers we are going to using atomic centers, and boilers we are going to using, and some of the means aero engines we are going to using. So over there only very high temperatures only we are going to using. Generally this we are not going to using continuous temperatures, very small intervals. Suppose that 1 minute, 2 minute, we cannot use it. Very long time we can use this one. It's one of the disadvantages will be there. Okay, these are the according to that pyrometers we can once again we will really reveal that one from working of the pyrometer. So we can reveal that why, because some this is a very important pyrometer. So that's why I am revealing this one. Only this, there is no contact of this one, and then radiation of the source is going to be emitted, okay, optical object to lens, okay, and then the observer should can watch that process entire with the help of eyepiece, and corrects in the manner that reference lamp and flame very sharp focus, and then the filament is superimposed. That's one of the very good advantages in that pyrometer. Generally the observer starts changing the rheostat. We can change that whenever the temperature will be raised, so that this stand will take that changes of intensity. So whenever intensity is going to be changes, so we can use we can measure it very accurately with the help of, and minimum temperature we can measure 700 degrees centigrade. Okay, right, thank you for this measurements. We can discuss next class.